Hello, this is Professor Kitch, and welcome to this webcast on Section 11.2. In this webcast, we'll discuss how to compute the time rate of settlement. When you're finished with this webcast, you should be able to define the degree of consolidation for a soil layer and contrast that degree of consolidation with the degree of pore pressure dissipation. They're not exactly the same thing. We'll discuss the methods for determining the degree of consolidation in this webcast, and you should be able to use the simplified solution to either determine how much settlement has occurred at a given time or determine how long it will take to reach a certain level of settlement. The solution to the simplified method is presented in Figure 11.6, Table 11.1, and Equations 11.24 and 11.25. In our previous modules on the rate of consolidation, we solved Terzaghi's 1D consolidation theory and used this solution to determine how excess pore pressure can change at points within a consolidating layer. This is valuable information, but it doesn't answer some important questions our clients need to know, questions related to the rate of settlement. Questions like, how much settlement will occur a year after construction? Or, when will the consolidation be done? These are clearly key questions to be answered, so let's answer them. Computing settlement versus time is simply a process of combining the magnitude of settlement computations we learned in Chapter 10 with the pore pressure dissipation computations we just learned in Module 11.1. An example will illustrate the process best. Let's consider the doubly drained soil layer shown here, with the strain versus log effective stress shown below it. We'll assume a fill has just been placed on the ground surface, and we have this initial excess pore pressure distribution. Our objective is to compute the consolidation settlement as a function of time. The process starts by computing the ultimate consolidation settlement using the techniques we learned in Chapter 10. We then divide the compressible layer into sublayers for computations. For accurate computations, we'll need as many as 50 sublayers, but for our illustration, we'll show just a few. We then start a cyclical process where we increment time by a small amount, delta T. The excess pore pressure will start to dissipate, as shown by the new isochrone. We now perform a series of computations for each sublayer. First, we compute the pore pressure for each sublayer using the static pore pressure plus the current excess pore pressure determined from our isochrone. We then compute the vertical effective stress for each layer using our effective stress equation. And with the effective stress known, we can compute the strain in each sublayer using our strain versus effective stress relationship. With the strain, we can compute the settlement for each sublayer. Once we've done these computations for all the sublayers, we can add up the settlement of each sublayer and determine the total consolidation settlement at the current time. And we can plot that point on our graph of settlement versus time. We'll then go back to step 3, increment time, and repeat the whole process. At each step, we'll be able to compute a new consolidation settlement, and we continue the process until consolidation is done and we have a complete consolidation versus time curve. We'll define the degree of consolidation U as the consolidation settlement at any given time divided by the ultimate consolidation settlement. While this is conceptually a simple process, it's computationally very tedious and can't reasonably be done by hand. It requires a computer program to accurately perform the calculations. So we need a simpler solution, which we can do with hand calculations. To get to a simpler solution, let's look at how pore pressure dissipates in our consolidating layer. We know that as excess pore pressure dissipates, the soil settles. We already learned how to compute the excess pore pressure at any point in the layer at any time using the isochrones in Figure 11.4. With this information, we can define the degree of pore pressure dissipation at a point as the initial excess pore pressure minus the current excess pore pressure divided by the initial excess pore pressure. At the start of consolidation, UI is equal to UE, and the degree of excess pore pressure is zero. At the end of consolidation, UE is equal to zero, and the degree of excess pore pressure dissipation is 100%. This is helpful, but what we really want to know is the average degree of excess pore pressure dissipation for the entire consolidating layer, U sub E. To calculate U sub E, we simply integrate the excess pore pressure across the entire height of the soil element. Or, UE is the integral of the initial excess pore pressure from 0 to 2H, minus the integral of the current excess pore pressure from 0 to 2H, divided by the integral of the initial excess pore pressure. We can illustrate this graphically. The integral of the initial excess pore pressure is simply the yellow rectangle, and the integral of the current excess pore pressure at a certain point in time, in this case when TV is equal to 0.4, is the brown area. There's a series solution to UE shown here. It's simply an integration of the series solution to Terzaghi's consolidation theory we covered in Module 11.1. If we assume that the soil is linearly elastic, then we can show that the degree of consolidation is equal to the degree of pore pressure dissipation, or U is equal to UE. We call this the simplified solution in your text. Using this solution, we can compute the consolidation settlement at any point in time as the degree of pore pressure dissipation times the ultimate consolidation settlement. The assumption that the soil is linear elastic is a bit confusing. We're still using our nonlinear strain versus log effective stress curve to determine the ultimate consolidation settlement. We're just using the simplifying assumption to compute the time rate of settlement. As with our other solutions for excess pore pressure dissipation, we can compute the degree of consolidation as a function of our dimensionless time factor, T sub V. This graph shows this relationship along with two equations that have been fit to the solution. So we can use either this graph or the equations to compute the degree of consolidation versus the time factor. This graph is presented in your text as figure 11.6, and the equations are 11.24 and 11.25. This is the same information presented in tabular form, which is table 11.1. We can use either figure 11.6, equations 11.24 and 11.25, or table 11.1 to determine the simplified version of the average degree of consolidation. And then we compute the consolidation settlement, delta C, as U times delta C ultimate. Remember, this is a simplified solution, and there will be some differences between it and the more accurate computer-based solutions. This figure will give you an idea of how much these two solutions can differ. The actual difference depends upon the specific problem being solved, but the gray area shown gives you a general idea of the range of answers that are possible. Note that as time increases, the simplified solution becomes more accurate. Let's illustrate how to do these computations with an example. We'll solve a portion of example 11.3 by hand. Here, we're given a 10 meter thick compressible clay layer with the properties shown, and a 3.2 meter thick fill is to be placed on the ground surface. We'll skip the computations for the ultimate consolidation settlement. They're shown in your text. The value of delta C ultimate is 471 millimeters. The first question we'll ask is how much settlement occurs 5 years after the fill is placed. First, we must define the time factor representing 5 years in our problem. This will be C sub B, 0.0021 meters squared per day, times time, 5 years, times 365 days per year, divided by 5 meters squared, which will be 0.153. We'll use equation 11.24 to compute U from the time factor and find that the simplified degree of consolidation is 44.2%. We'll then compute the degree of consolidation at 5 years to be 44.2% of 471, or 208 millimeters. Another question we might ask is how long it will take to reach 95% consolidation. Using table 11.1, we'll find that the time factor, TV, for 90% consolidation is 1.13. We then use our equation for the time factor to calculate the actual time. In this case, 1.13 times 5 meters squared divided by C sub V, 0.0021 meters squared per day, which will be 13,450 days, or 36.9 years. An important point to make here is that the theoretical time to 100% consolidation is infinity. It's not very helpful to tell our clients that it will take an infinite amount of time for the consolidation to be complete on their project. We need to remember that this is just a theoretical solution, and from a practical standpoint, consolidation will be complete sooner. So we generally assume that the theoretical time to 95% consolidation represents complete consolidation. Just to give you an idea of the difference between our simplified solution and the more accurate computer solution, we compare the two in this figure, taken from example 11.3 in your text. You'll see here that the two solutions are very similar. There's more uncertainty in our soil properties than in a difference between these two solutions. So let's summarize. The proper definition of the degree of consolidation is the current consolidation settlement divided by the ultimate consolidation settlement. Computing the degree of consolidation is tedious and requires using a computer program. The simplified solution assumes that the degree of excess pore pressure dissipation is equal to the degree of consolidation. This solution allows for easy hand computations using charts, tables, or simple equations. It implicitly assumes that the soil is linearly elastic and is generally an adequate solution for simple problems. Theoretically, consolidation goes on forever. For practical purposes, we usually assume 95% consolidation represents full consolidation.
It's a stop, it's a stop, it's a stop, amigo.